woman Judy Griffin. Congratulations to the Southside High School graduating class of 2021. Although it was a challenging year, you made it. This achievement is a direct result of all your hard work, dedication, and determination. I also want to take this time to thank Principal John Murphy, school staff, teachers, and parents for all of your support and diligence this year to this graduating class. As a Rockville Center resident myself and proud mom of four Southside High School graduates, I am honored to be able to represent each of you in Albany. I know that you will all continue to do great things as you go on to pursue your dreams, and I look forward to following your future endeavors. I'll leave you with this quote from Anatole France. To accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe. Thank you and congratulations again. Doing it all night, all summer, gonna spend it like no other. It was a crush, but I couldn't get enough. It was a rush, but I gave it up. It was a crush, now I might have wanna say too much, but that's all it was, so I gave it up. I live my day as if it was the last, live my day as if it was no past.
Through. It's right before my eyes and I can take it if it's what I want to do. I am leaving and this is starting to feel like it's right before my eyes and I can taste it. It's my sweet beginning. I can tell just what you want. You don't want to be alone. You don't want to be alone. I can't say it's what you know, but you know.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Good morning, family, friends. Welcome to graduation. We will be starting promptly in approximately 9 minutes with the processional. In case anyone was wondering, yes, this is what a lovely summer's day looks like in Ireland. Enjoy the ceremony. We'll be back in 10 minutes.
You don't want to be alone. You don't want to be alone. Hi, Southside. This is Senator Todd Kaminsky, and I'm so proud of all you have accomplished. Unlike decades and decades of years of students at Southside, you've had to endure especially difficult circumstances that I believe at the end will make you stronger. It realizes how important your community is, how much we all have to rely on each other, and how with dedication, hard work, and fortitude, we could overcome anything. So as you go to the next level, whether it's at college, the military, or in the workforce, I know that you'll carry with you the confidence and determination that's required to get anything done. I believe in you. And if you believe in yourself and want to work hard, you could accomplish anything. So good luck. Have a great summer. Know that we're all behind you, this entire community, for whatever is next. And don't take any you-know-what from anybody. Congratulations.
Good morning. I am New York State Assemblywoman Judy Griffin. Congratulations to the Southside High School graduating class of 2021. Although it was a challenging year, you made it. This achievement is a direct result of all your hard work, dedication, and determination. I also want to take this time to thank Principal John Murphy, school staff, teachers, and parents for all of your support and diligence this year to this graduating class. As a Rockville Center resident myself and proud mom of four Southside High School graduates, I am honored to be able to represent each of you in Albany. I know that you will all continue to do great things as you go on to pursue your dreams, and I look forward to following your future endeavors. I'll leave you with this quote from Anatole France. To accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe. Thank you and congratulations again.
Take a breath, let us turn to ripples.
Esteemed friends, it is my honor as principal of Southside High School to officially open commencement exercises for the class of 2021. Please be seated. Ms. Skylar DeLuca, president of the Student Government Association, will begin this proceeding. Skylar?
Welcome to the Southside High School graduation ceremony. My name is Skylar DeLuca, and I'm the president of the student government at Southside High School. Please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing as we listen to the senior members of the Chamber Singers sing the Star Spangled Banner. Extend my gratitude to the class of 2021. It has been a pleasure being your SGA president this year. I know we have been through a lot, but we finally made it. Thank you and congratulations. And now here is Mr. Murphy.
Please be seated. The salutatorian of the class of 2021 is Sophia Romanello. She's an up. Yeah. She is an outstanding young woman and a scholar. I look forward to hearing her comments. Sophia?
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Southside High School's class of 2021 graduation. I know it's early and it's outdoors and it's even a little rainy, but at least it's not a Zoom call. Thank you to Mr. Murphy and all the other administrators who made this live graduation possible. And thank you to our teachers, parents, and families for all the support and love you have given us. Class of 2021, I have a confession to make. I've known many of you for a long time, but not all of you know that I am a terrible procrastinator. So after a full month without classes and no deadlines, well, you can only imagine how hard it was to write the speech this morning. But seriously, How do you perfectly capture what a high school experience means to everyone? You can't. But I'm going to try. 4 years ago, as a younger and possibly smaller freshman, you walked into Southside High School. And 4 years later, on either a red day or a blue day, you walked through those doors again. As Mr. Murphy aptly put it at this year's freshman orientation, you breathed life back into the building. And it may have seemed as if from that first day of freshman year to the first day of our senior year, not much had changed. Maybe, if you're like me, you still look like you're that small little freshman. But there were differences, even if you didn't notice them at first. Maybe when you walked through those doors for the first time freshman year, you didn't have, say, a favorite mural. Senior Sophia loved seeing those little dog murals that designate different departments. Freshman Sophia didn't even know the difference between the math wing and the chemistry wing. Maybe as a senior, you have places that aren't just places anymore. Maybe the back of an English classroom isn't just where you pretended to read Frankenstein at 7:50 in the morning. Maybe it's where you met your best friend. Maybe a random Spanish classroom isn't just where you conjugated verbs. Maybe it's where you promised your ninth period class you'd give them a shout out in your graduation speech. Maybe some random spot next to the history wing isn't where you learned about major battles. Maybe it's where you fought your own for a plastic baby. Things may have seemed the same when you walked through those doors of Southside as a senior, but I know that all those familiar places are now connected with fond memories. I'm sure there's also been a lot of change within yourself that you might not have noticed. After 4 years, you're more confident, more self-assured. You may have found new interests and passions or new friends. Like the price of a cafeteria muffin, you've grown each year. And perhaps, if you are like me, you didn't realize that it's all the little moments through the last 4 years, some good, some bad, that have shaped who we are now. Looking back, I know it wasn't walking beside the float during the homecoming parade that was important. It was all those late nights in my garage with many of you, painting, having pizza, and laughing as we practiced our songs and dances. For many of us, it wasn't about the perfect show or the perfect game. It was all the practices and hard work and time spent together that has made us who we are. So, if we take away any lesson from our high school experience, it should be to appreciate all the little moments. Don't be an onlooker in your life, waiting for the perfect moment to celebrate. As we've learned over the last year and a half, you never know when your ability to have a say in what is to come will be taken from you. While you may look back at this ceremony as merely the bridge between your high school experience and your future, my wish is that you continue to have experiences, gain friendships, and build confidence, which continue to make you better and grow. Now, one last thing before I go. Although I promised my mother I'd keep the Taylor Swift references to a minimum, it just so happens that she's spoken some of the best advice I could possibly give you. Class of 2021, I remind you to never be so clever that you forget to be kind, and to never be so kind that you forget to be clever. Tonight, celebrate all your accomplishments with your loved ones and appreciate all the little moments that have made you who you are. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sophia. I have to remember to speak after the kids next time. Very intimidating. It's my pleasure to give the Centennial Award. For school spirit and community. If you put your mind to something, accomplish what needs to be done, push yourself more than the person next to you, then you accomplish anything. These words were written by this year's Centennial Award winner and exemplify the type of person he is. This impressive young man has been a go-getter since the time he walked through the threshold at Southside. He's intrinsically motivated, sets his bar higher for himself than he does others, and never needs a push to take on responsibilities. He works hard until the task is complete, time in and time out. Academically, he's a stellar student. He always makes achievement his highest priority. Over his high school years, he's carried the fullest schedule possible. The thought of lightening his load during any time in tribulation never even occurred to him. He recently required the full IB diploma requirements and thrives on challenging himself. Yet outside of the classroom, his resume is equally extensive. He's a leader, yet humble, soft-spoken, and leads by examples. Whether it's as a club officer in myriad clubs, a student mentor in SMILE, which is students making it a little easier, an advocate in athletes helping athletes, a camp counselor, an aide, a trainer, or a tutor, he knows how to lead respectfully, honestly, compassionately, reliably, and efficiently. He has also spent the last 14 years making wonderful contributions to the St. Baldrick's Foundation, where he has personally raised over $30,000. He is a natural-born leader who advocates for the best interest of others. He serves as a role model to his peers. He is innately driven and has a heart of gold, always offering and helping a hand to others. His level of ambition is equally admirable. I have no doubt that he will continue to thrive as he begins the next chapter of his life at the Kelly School of Business at Indiana University. It is with great pride that I present the Centennial Award for the class of 2021 to Mr. Brady Bender. It is also my pleasure to give the Richard S. Byers Award for School and Community Service. The Byers Award each year is given to a student who demonstrates the school spirit and exemplifies all that Southside High School stands for. This year's recipient welcomes challenges and has demonstrated this throughout each of the 4 years at Southside High School, also working towards a full IB diploma. Not surprisingly, this challenge was not just met with perseverance, effort and enthusiasm, but also with grace. With an eclectic and extensive resume, this student is most often busy with some activity or another. At any given point during the year, you will see this student involved in our theater and music programs, including chamber singers, IB theater, and student-directed plays. As a valuable member of the varsity lacrosse and cheerleading teams, she was captain for both this past year. As a former class president and current president of the Student Government Association, she was instrumental in organizing and implementing many successful school activities and maintaining the principal's sanity throughout the year. It is with a high level of energy and enthusiasm that she brings 100% effort to everything that she does. Her individuality and ability to stand on her own 2 feet will only be an asset to her future success. Planning to attend the University of Georgia this fall, the recipient of the Byers Award for 2021 is Skylar LeDuc. Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Jun Chang, will now present the Laurel Awards. Mr. Chang.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to present the Laurel Awards for 2021 graduating class. This year's male Laurel Awards recipient is a full international baccalaureate diploma candidate, far exceeding the requirements of creativity, activity, and service. His determination and motivation are abundant and exemplified by his always taking more incentive classes than is required. He was a dedicated member of the Chamber Singers for 3 years, taking the opportunity to explore his creativity while remaining devoted to academics. He showed perseverance in everything he does, thinks critically, and constantly strives for deeper knowledge. This amazing young man's resume is a collaboration of community service and activities. He demonstrates natural-born leadership skills within our school and community in multiple ways. He serves as the president of the Cancer Awareness Club, where he was responsible for helping to organize Relay for Life event. As president of the debate club, he moderated the weekly forums and provided information on topics prior to the debate. He's been the class president for his grade for 3 years and works closely with the Student Government Association. He became a co-founder and co-president of the Safe Club. He is also a member of DECA, where he competes in regional and state competitions. As a social media coordinator for the Political Awareness Club, he runs the Twitter account and keeps its followers informed of events. He has enjoyed managing the boys' soccer team for 4 years, where he's organized the equipment, manages the books and stats. He was selected to be the leader in the Athletes Helping Athletes, which gave him the opportunity to be a positive role model to the elementary school students. All that he has accomplished, both academically and personally, comes secondary to the fact that he is an exceptional young man with integrity and great strength of character. The halls of Southside High School will not be the same without him and his significant contributions next year. Attending Fordham University in the fall, the male recipient of the Laurel Awards is Emilio Grillo. Leadership does not depend solely on one's control over others, but rather how well one can motivate others to bring about their best selves. When I read the statement written by this year's Laurel Award recipient, I instantly nod my head in agreement. This impressive young lady is a true leader in every aspect of life, academically, socially, and through her involvement in extracurricular activities. She shines academically, having recently completed the prestigious IB diploma requirements. She has thrived learning at this intense level and is truly a teacher's dream. She has been referred to as a warm, sensitive soul who brings great joy and comfort to her peers in the classroom, an extremely patient and articulate and talented individual, and a sophisticated student who asks creative questions no matter what the subject entails. She leaves a lasting impression on her teachers. Outside of the classroom, this unstoppable young lady has an extensive resume filled with worthwhile activities, the majority of which revolve around helping others, whether she is making blankets for cancer patients, raising money for pediatric cancer, leading her class as an officer, or teaching seniors a dance. Her heart always points in the right direction. No matter what the task, she leads by example and serves as a true role model. This year's Laurel Award winner is a young woman who exemplifies qualities we all strive to instill in ourselves. She is special for so many reasons. She is mature, intelligent, conscientious, and caring. She has a strong desire to excel, is eager to make changes in the world, and she is exactly the type of young lady who gets the job done. She will proudly attend the University of Delaware's Honors Program, where I'm confident she will continue to thrive, and so it is with great pride that I am able to dedicate the Laurel Award for Class of 2021 to Sydney Brancaccio.
Congratulations can't be said often enough today. The valedictorian for the class of 2021, Mr. Ethan Steer, will deliver his address. He's a remarkable scholar and a compassionate, caring classmate. Ethan, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Murphy. Teachers, families, administrators, staff, and students of the class of 2021, I never imagined I'd be where I am right now. I stand before you today as valedictorian of the Southside High School class of 2021. And with this honor, I've earned the privilege of one last special homework assignment. A speech in a wizard costume that lives on the internet forever. Today I want to start with a story about a boy. The year's 1989, he's 17 years old, roughly the age we are today, and he's left his home in South Africa to go to college, halfway around the world at Queen's University in Canada, and then later at the University of Pennsylvania here in the States. In the 13 years that follow, he starts and sells two companies, giving him a nine-figure net worth and all the material possessions he could possibly imagine. Elon Musk had money, and lots of it. Why then, in 2018, did he sleep on the assembly floor of the Tesla factory because they weren't meeting production targets? Why did he even start another company in the first place? It seems money was not the end game for him. There was something else motivating him, likely a combination of things. Maybe he really wanted to electrify the automotive industry. Maybe he really wanted the status of being a true disruptor and innovator. I can't be sure exactly. These are only guesses, but one thing is clear. Elon Musk doesn't just work for money. It's something else. He has a vision and is motivated by a deep sense of mission and purpose to bring this vision to reality. I think that this is a fairly basic observation. What's less obvious is that many Tesla employees are also putting in these ridiculous hours because of him. Nobody changes the world by themselves. The best leaders are able to articulate their vision to others around them. They're able to transform their company from a business into a movement. Think about how Tesla is the most valuable automaker in the world. Not because the cars is already manufactured and sold, but because of the widespread belief in Elon and expectations of innovations yet to come. It's a sweet deal for the rest of us. They make huge personal sacrifices, and we get an electric car that goes from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds and can nearly drive itself. Now it's our turn to go out into the world and make a difference. Let me explain why that's important by traveling to 1977. NASA has launched the Voyager 1 probe to study the outer solar system, to go farther than anything else before. 12 years later, as it reaches Saturn and completes its initial mission, NASA engineers instruct it to turn around and take one last photograph of Earth. That photograph has become famous, and it's often referred to as the pale blue dot. It shows planet Earth as an almost impossibly small point of light in an otherwise vast empty space. And I don't mention this picture, as it is often used, to make a point about our physical insignificance in the universe, but instead to call attention to our isolation. Sometimes people ask, if you were stranded on a desert island, who would you take with you? In realizing that we are just a pale blue dot in our greater surroundings, it becomes obvious that we actually are all stranded on a desert island, a cosmic desert island, if you will. And you might look around to the people around you and think, well, I wouldn't have brought you with me to mine, but that's already been decided. We are all stuck on this planet. We are all that we have. And that makes us a team whether we like it or not. Today is a big moment for us. A high school graduation is a big step towards entering the real world. It brings us closer to a time when we'll have to take over for the generation that's currently in charge. It will soon be incumbent upon us to safeguard and sustain and grow our species. We have demonstrated an ability to learn and improve, to get stronger under stress, not weaker, but that's not guaranteed to continue. The current innovators, like Elon, will not last forever, and we'll have to provide new ones. We will need people to set aside leisure and fun if we want to build upon the foundation that's been left for us. But I can't ask you all to do what I haven't done, and instead would like to end on a slightly different note. For any of you listening now who decide that they will answer the call to push humanity forward, today's leaders have left us something to help. You will need an objective and mission that compels you and those around you beyond material gain to pursue it. I think that if you do that, the world will know your name for generations to come. Thank you.
It is now my honor to introduce Ms. Tara Hackett, President of the Board of Education.
Good morning. My name is Tara Hackett, and it is my honor as President and on behalf of the Rockville Center Board of Education to have the privilege to congratulate the Southside High School Class of 2021. To be able to address this particular group of students who have embodied great strength, resilience and grace will always be one of the highlights of my board tenure, so I thank you for this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's also my honor for me to address you from this particular location where I graduated from Hofstra University in this very stadium. I also spent 6 years working as the alumni director in the building right to the left of us. In that time, I bore witness to multiple commencement ceremonies annually and celebrated the accomplishments of thousands of graduates. Though I have heard upwards of 100 graduation speeches over those years, the ones that always stayed with me were the ones that imparted words of positivity, and that is what I pledge to you today. Since our memory is most vivid surrounding our life's milestones, I wanted to draw inspiration from the lessons I remember from that time of my life. About a year before my college graduation, the musical Rent, a modern take on the famous opera La Boheme, debuted on Broadway. Though it's been 25 years since it took a stage, I believe there are some timely and evergreen messages I'd like to share with you. The first one is that we have 525,600 minutes in a year to make a difference. Through that song, Seasons of Love, we are challenged to not only contemplate how we might choose to spend those minutes, but more importantly, the way we might measure our lives. As you reflect on this past year, you'll undoubtedly remember what you overcame to get here, but I urge you to focus on what you had to celebrate this year instead. The song lyrics are 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in strife. How do you measure a year? How about love? Life is certainly a series of choices, and how we view our lives is no exception. We can choose the light and the love, and we can remember a year in the life of friends. I hope you remember your senior year this way. Another poignant lesson to take away from Rent is the mantra, no day but today. To me, this is a modern take on the classic motto, carpe diem, or seize the day. Those four simple words, no day but today, perfectly capture how we should wake up every day. The lyrics metaphorically stress there is no future and there is no past. Our past is a part of what made us, but there's no sense dwelling on it. After all, we aren't headed there. And there's no sense fearing the future. Because of who we are today, we will be prepared for anything. We will put on our brave faces, shoulders back, facing the sun, and we will take on the day. We should focus on the here and the now. We should be present. As he says, forget regret, or life is yours to miss. Give in to love or live in fear. No other path, no other way, no day but today. So take it all in right now. Look around, remember the faces, the smiles, the laughter, and the pride. You will reflect upon this day throughout your life. And though you might not remember me, I'll certainly never forget you. It goes without saying that we are all incredibly impressed with each and every one of you and so proud of what you've accomplished this year. For what you withstood, for what you gave up, and for what you may have lost. But here you are loved, and you have everything you need to take on tomorrow and every day after. I wish so many things for each of you, but what I wish for you most, class of 2021, is a pure celebration of life and love. Congratulations and best of luck for your future.
Thank you, Ms. Hackett. Cue the sun. Okay, we're ready. Graduates, family, faculty, and friends, I'll be brief, I promise. But this morning we do come together one last time to congratulate and celebrate the class of 2021 for all their hard work and reaching the important milestones in their lives. And it's a milestone for not just you, but your families, your friends. And I ask and I beg your indulgence that this afternoon after the car parade and the dust settles, there's a pattern that emerges after you go to a couple of these, and that the speeches that are said during graduation form a pattern of themselves, and they become part of a theme. It's called the zeitgeist, the time ghost, that's reflective of the times that we live in. They're usually not predicted, but people tend to form a pattern, and if you look at the speeches as a group, they tend to tell you what's been going on and what the wishes are for the future. As is my wont, I will not be offering you advice today. The large part of that is that I'm old enough to understand that 10 and 15 years from now, the likelihood of you understanding the world better than I is significantly greater as the years go on. I know that because this was a special week for me too. My oldest daughter finally finished graduate school and she's gainfully employed. Yay! Yay me! Yes, that will happen to you sometime, and I know that the future is being written by you and her because she explained to me what her job is, and people are asking me, so what is Holly doing? And my response is, I don't know. She's explained it to me three times, and I still don't understand it. Well, I know she's getting a paycheck. That will probably happen to you, too. So I'm giving up predicting the future, right? Like I've given up predicting on whether it's going to rain. 2017, I would have lost. We were indoors. But it rained on us, right? Rain this year. Look, it rained on prom night, right? But the tents outside let us use the outdoors, and it almost doubled the space that we had available to us that we normally would. This is a pattern, right? Awards night wasn't what we wanted to, but we celebrated more of you than we have in the history of Southside High School. Even though there's been restrictions on this event, And we did wipe the seats twice, just for clarification. In September, I was hoping and praying that we would be back in Southside on June 25th to celebrate you. So I guess my wish did come true, just not in the ways that I had envisioned it. Varsity S Awards, field day, yearbook signing, and the car parades were celebrations that gave you the opportunity to enjoy each other's company. By the way, reminder, lineup, car parade, 12:15, last shout out, okay? The list goes on and on. Even in the best of times, we may not be receiving that which we wanted, but there were successes and victories even in those shortcomings. It's up to you, as we leave here, to decide which side of that argument and which side of the narrative you're going to retain and make part of your memories. I promise the following is not advice. It's just a compilation of what people have told me, especially about you, over the last 2 weeks. It's a little bit of science and a lot of love. And however it falls for you, suit yourself. Apparently, psychology understand that our brains evolved much slower over time than our world does. In other words, the lives that we live in right now are trying to catch up to brain development because our brains evolve much more slowly. Your brain is designed, cognitive scientists tell us, for one thing. The predominant thing is survive and be safe. In other words, given the choice between happy, successful, and safe, your brain chooses safe every single time. That's going to be your first instinct, and that's going to be your brain's proclivity. Now, you could override that instinct and choose the latter, but you're going to have to overcome those instincts if you do so. Psychologists tell us that there's an instinct, it's called negativity bias, that we're all hotwired for. It's a survival instinct since when we were living in caves. Negativity bias is a really good asset. It helps us sort out and look for problems, threats, and issues so that we are able to confront them. It's a great survival instinct. But it's an overdrive, and its job is to keep you safe, not to keep you successful, and not to keep you happy. In times of crisis and trauma, negativity bias kicks into overdrive. So if you are going through a series of issues, your brain doesn't care. All it wants to do is keep you safe. So it looks for the negative. It looks for the threat. It looks for the next problem. We're also given free will. It's what separates us. And we have a chance to operate and rise above those instincts. Negativity bias is a huge asset, but if we let it run amok, we live in a world that has nothing but problems, nothing but threats, nothing but issues. But there's more. We need to remember that in the midst of all the unspeakable tragedies and trauma, we prevailed. This year, we felt vulnerable, afraid, frustrated, and at times helpless. But we've also been surrounded by unbelievable acts of love, kindness, and solidarity. In our all too isolated lives, we need to remember that there are times when we finally had the opportunity to reconnect and regain social norms. I still remember the day when you guys came back and we were off hybrid for the first time. We need to remember that despite the unspeakable, there is positive. There are life-affirming attributes that we deserve to focus on and to overcome the negativity bias that has kept us safe but has not ensured our happiness nor our connectedness. Remember, in the days ahead, you are resilient, smart, flexible, and stronger than you know. You are not broken. On the contrary, you've been made stronger than the year that's passed. You were at your best when you came together and you focused on your common interests rather than your differences. Please, I'm begging, use these experiences to focus on your strengths and the positive. Remember that the creative ways that you use to stay connected will always be there. Remember that what it felt like when the restrictions and the barriers started to be lifted. Remember the times when you offered a hand to somebody else or somebody else did the same to you. Remember your fondest memories of Jameson Novello and the love and friendship that you shared as you ensured that she is part of your everyday, your today, and your tomorrow. And let those life-affirming attributes give you purpose. Let that be her legacy. And remember that we could fill this stadium five times over with people who love, support, and are so proud of you today. We can't control the past, but we most certainly are in control of how we use our future. You will forever be part of my fondest memories and the legacy of success that will continue at Southside High School. Congratulations. A school is founded on the work of the faculty. Southside High School has a rich tradition of dedicated, talented, and compassionate teachers. Before the class of 2021 prepares to receive their diplomas, I'm here to tell you that there's been a greater attendance of staff and faculty than in my 26 years at Southside High School, and I went back to prior principals, than in the last 35 years. That's a testament to your character, your professional, and the number of people who wanted to be here. So can we please give a round of applause? Please stand to be counted to the staff and faculty of Southside High School. A school leader and a school also exists in a context. Rockville Center is our context, and the dignitaries who share the dais with us symbolize the support that Southside receives from the extended community. A special welcome to Mayor Francis X. Murray, Mayor of Rockville Center. Mr. Emilio Grillo, Trustee, Village of Rockville Center. Dr. Gene Harris, Co-President, Southside High School PTA. Ms. Cindy Vopel, Co-President, Southside High School PTA. Round of applause for our guests. Thank you. The school district and administrators and your Board of Education created and facilitated the policies which make for great schools. In the case of the class of 2021, you have been fortunate that bold and caring measures, ample budgets, and a demanding presence has characterized our central office and Board of Education. Here today we have Ms. Tara Hackett, President of the Board of Education. Ms. Christine Farazani, Secretary, Board of Education. And Mr. John O'Shea, Trustee, Board of Education. We are also fortunate to have Mr. Jun Chang, Superintendent of Schools. Dr. Noreen Leahy, Assistant Superintendent for Pupil Personnel and Special Education. Dr. Janine Sampino, Assistant Superintendent. Dr. Brian Zuar, Director of Music, Performing, Fine Arts, and Practical Arts. Ms. Carol Rosetto, Director of Physical Education, Interscholastic Athletics, and Health. And Ms. Sonia Hood, Central Director of Curriculum and Instruction. Before we get back to you, there's just one more housekeeping event. You're not the only ones leaving us this year. There are three people who have had long and storied careers at Southside High School, and they will be the first recipients of this year's diplomas. First and foremost, this is her last day as well. I'd like to offer an honorary Southside diploma to Dr. Noreen Leahy, Assistant Superintendent. And in our audience, they don't even have to come this far up. There are two other people who had the audacity to leave with you. Ms. Laurie Levy. Palumbo, make your way to Mr. Rosenthal to receive your honorary diploma. No, it does not mean you can come to alumni night. It's honorary. And now, Mr. Chang, members of the Board of Education, we are proud to present the graduating class of 2021. I attest that they have completed the graduation requirements prescribed by the New York State Department of Education and the Rockville Center Board of Education, and therefore are eligible to receive their high school diplomas.
Valedictorian Ethan Steer. Salutatorian and senior class vice president Sophia Romanello. Senior class president, Emilio Grillo. Senior class secretary, Janelle Melendez. Senior class treasurer, Sydney Brancaccio. SGA President, Skylar DeLuca. SGA First Vice President, Caitlin Espiritu. SGA Second Vice President, Madeline Wolfram. SGA Secretary, Ashlyn Boje. SGA Treasurer, Brady Bender. Olivia Moore. Jack Richmond. Rosemary Hassan. Courtney Kanyuk. Megan Fennessy. Matthew Cavallo. William Reuter. Tina Johnson. William Capuano. Liam Galvin. Alejandro Monroy Jr. Brendan Leavenworth. Ryan McHugh. Joshua Zwerin. Maximo Lin. Jack McEnany. Dylan Cuevas. Chrisel Perez Canella. Kevin Bazile. A Aiden Wilson. Christian Ocasio. Justin Pena. Michael Buglioni. Arvin Zelaya. Russell McQuillan. Nelson Vargas de la Cruz. Eduardo Rodriguez. Caleb Taran. Christina Andorfer. Victoria Pazulo. Molly Murray. Kathleen Egan. Charles Cosina. Michaela Hendry. Ryan O'Donnell. Shannon Morgan. Justin Schmidt. Lila Nakari. Joseph Lubin. Catherine Bohan. Amy Sclafani. Brooke Barshak. Margaret O'Brien. Ariana Alamo. Madison Brower. Jacqueline Locasano. Erin Agolia. Jillian Pinsky. Camille Charvet. Kiera Reed. Jacques Charvet. Marlena Fogelberg. Madeline McGovern. Elizabeth Quilty. Margaret Connors. Anna Bingham. Catherine Sweeney. Caroline O'Connor. Kaylee Owens. Christy Sheik. Alexander Fishkin. Joshua Barnes. Timothy Warner. James Travers. Caleb Hardley Ferens. Brianna Morante. Eric Moreno. Ava Lang. Ryan Habacker. Lisa Patton. Madison Alcock. Afrin Syed Shakat. Jessica Agajanov. Christina Martino. Karen Hansen. Grace Senken. Madison Gamberg. Madeline Roberti. Kirsten Quirk. Isabella Di Pietro. Montana Mawini. Michael Grabowski. Catherine McGetrick. Sebastian Rivas. Maggie Rose Ferrick. Yeah, Maggie! Casey Shargle. Noel Russo. Jack Duncan. Daniel Seidenstein. Cameron Forms. Kristen Longworth. Kirsten Green. Olivia Roach Fleming. Anna Ludwig. Jude Weithaler. Grace Egan. Sydney Levine. Ava Honorado. Caitlin Pearson. Joelle Gregoire Lincoln. John Anthony Cipriano. Thomas Haggerty. Sean Crotier. Aiden Berman. Owen Moroz. Matthew Walter. Matthew Byrne. Samir Syed. Matthew Funes. Matthew Mon. James Guardino. Amy Lamuto. Catherine Schaefer. Anna O'Sullivan. Catherine O'Neill. Faith Lamacchia. Jamie Mann. Caitlin Davis. Sydney Rathjen. Megan Sheehan. Dana Allen. Ann Sautner. Timothy Mohammed. Cameron Wallace. Owen Ferreira. Aiden Algios. John Quinn. Owen Mullen. William Tolkien. Matthew Lozito. Thomas Kelly. Charles McKeough. Matthew Melkonian. Nicholas Feinstein. Jack Schwartzberg. John Considine. Kiera Raming Venable. Jeanette Gonzalez. Alicia Chulo. Raquel Benjamin. Emilia O'Leary. Elisa Barker. Isabella Malone. Jackson Baki. Alyssa Redzimitovich. Sikona Dixon. Reed Plonsky. Christian Lucas. Michael Mincili. Max Nort. Paul Mata. Michael Pesch. Luke Southwick. Thomas Haney. Haley Satovia. Matthew Leone. Aaron Leonard. Jordan Nicotra. Jackson Grehan. Patrick Sandhas. Shayla Woodson. Madison Hayward. Helene Ruiz. Sarah Martineau. Nicholas Bravati. Isabella Idenilo. Delaney Michelizzi. Ava Wang. Olivia Duca. Avery Brule. Caitlin Riley. Jane Pusateri. Julia Bianco. Grace McDonald. Samantha Martino. Ava Locursio. Sophia Moon. Alexa Schaeffler. Jillian Shimkin. Marissa Merkins. Jacob Flaherty. Kiera Perez. Lauren Zola. Caroline Zola. Jacqueline Pozzulo. Erin Mei Chun Ping Peretz. Brendan O'Connell. Chase Evans. Thomas Eckrich. Jonathan Koziars. Lucas Boysen. Micheline Griffin. Alexander Goodstein. Dylan Saltzman. Tor O'Connell. Ella Grace Delmond. Sophie Federico.
Yes, sir!
Juliet Dyax. Yes, Christian Nicotra. Yes, Cole Manzi. Liam Tier. Timothy Sheehan. John Russo. Vasione Sinjari. Kyle Aramiscus. Matthew Cardi. James Hennessy. Kimberly Kraling. Hugh Roschert. Owen Burns. John Beatty. Grace Sands. Emma Garrett. Eleanor Quigley. Kellyanne McCarthy. Michaela McCormick. Elizabeth O'Brien. Sophia Jackson.
Yes, sir!
Priscilla Grima. Isabella Gutierrez. Marissa Mohan. Ella DeFrancisca. Juliana Mirza. Ava Morris. Zaire Robinson. Sean Kennedy. Christian DeRubio. Jack Temple. Connor Dotzler. John Kenny. Gordon Kutcher. Juan Negroni. Christopher Erickson. Anthony Rossiello. Matthew DeSalvo. Scott Restivo. Michael Gibney. Nicholas Tessar. Dylan Costello. Yeah.
Before I turn it over to Leo to say some closing remarks, I'd like to provide a little gift, which was compiled through Mr. Lichter, Ms. Voltaggio, our TV studio, and yearbook staff, a video retrospective for the class of 2021, which will appear on both videos, screens. Enjoy for your viewing pleasure.
Close your tired eyes, relax and then count from 1 to 10 and open them. All these heavy thoughts will try to weigh you down, but not this time. Way up in the air, you're finally free and you can stay up there right next to me. All this gravity will try to pull you down, but not this time. When the sun goes down and the lights burn out, then it's time for you to shine brighter than a shooting star. So shine no matter where you are. Fill the darkest night with a brilliant light, 'cause it's time for you to shine brighter than a shooting star. So shine no matter where you are. Our hearts, oh, the pouring rain, we'll try to put it out, but not this time. Let your colors burn and brightly burst into a million sparks that all disperse and illuminate a world that'll try to bring you down, but not this time. When the sun goes down and the lights burn out, then it's time for you to shine.
Thank you. Mr. Leo Grillo, president of the class, will offer his remarks. Leo?
Good morning, students, faculty, friends, and family. I want to personally thank all of you for coming this morning, even under the new circumstances. Although this isn't all of our best hours, it's so great to see all of you sitting in front of me today. Under the instruction of Mr. Murphy, I was advised to keep my speech brief and to the point, because as much as we all enjoyed being here this early, I know most of us have wonderful celebrations to get to. 4 years ago, I stood like this in front of all of you, much shorter and much, much more annoying, giving a very similar speech at our middle school graduation. But now, I'm standing on a different stage and can observe how much each and every one of you have grown in different ways. We have gone through so much as a class from the start to the finish of our high school careers. This year especially, we really had to come together as a group and make the most out of our last year of high school. In November, the finish line seemed like it was a long way ahead. And along the way, all there was going to be was homework, tests, quizzes, and a never-ending cycle of environmental system assignments. However, our year began to turn around. We all got to come back full-time, sports got to have their seasons, and most importantly, the free bagels and gym kickball. But enough about the long year that we had. I think instead of focusing on the many bumps in the road in the past year, we should look to the future. As we are going our separate ways, it's important to look at who we are and what we are destined to do. But this is an interesting question, right? We have spent our entire high school careers preparing for that. However, there's no easy way to answer this. Some people do know exactly who they are and what they want to do in life. And if that's you, your parents are probably doing a big sigh of relief right now. But some of us might not, and that's okay. Well, your parents might not think so when you're on your fourth major and they're still paying your tuition, but I promise you that it's okay. High school is fun, but now we are devoting our lives to discovering our passions, whatever that may be. Now is the time to learn what we want to be and to pursue our dreams. The development that we have endured over the past 4 years was crucial in understanding what we are going to do in the next stages of our lives. I can't wait to see what our generation is on the way to achieve. To close, I want to add the perfect words that, in my opinion, sum up our experiences at Southside. At the end of our English class this year, my teacher, Mrs. Harnden, who is one of the most influential educators I've ever had the pleasure of being taught by, 2 years in a row, compiled a poem of all of our words about high school. We were asked to write a brief response reflecting on our 4 years, and she put them together into a work of art. My class's final words were, "Resonate 4 years of your life. Your aura has changed completely. From age 14 to 18, you are totally different. In high school, you change so much and start to desire and repel different things. It is chaotic, it is confusing, and also exhilarating, much like a tornado or like a cyclone." And with that, class of 2021, I invite you to please rise and turn your tassels to the left because we finally did it. Congratulations, everyone. We just graduated high school.
About time. God, they're so compliant. Okay, thank you, Mr. Lichter, Mr. Kroger. The video production of this graduation event will be shown on the school channel. Thank you to Mr. Murray, Ms. Vopel, Dr. Harris, County Executive Laura Curran, Judy Griffin, Senator Kaminsky, and the Hofstra University staff. And now a round of applause for the Southside High School class of 2021. All right, grads, processional. Go out and get your diplomas. Have a good afternoon. See you at the parking lot for the parade.